Prototypes are an indispensable tool for product developers. They can help in various situations, such as proving the concept of a product, showing its functionality before it is produced, and helping to solve problems. They are also a good way of expressing your idea to other stakeholders. But what do we mean when we are talking about prototypes? Let's look at a definition which is given by a scientist named Kohler. A prototype is an artifact that is an approximation to the final product. Therefore, a prototype has a lot in common with an unfinished product, but with the difference that a prototype was created specifically for a specific purpose and can therefore also be created from other materials or with a different technology. Depending on the material, the prototype can be touchable or experienceable. Prototypes have various applications. You can use them for exploration when you want to win hypotheses, for specification in order to recognize boundary conditions, for demonstrations to prove that your solution is working, as a selection to evaluate multiple ideas and select the best one, or to document your decisions or knowledge, for example, in your product profile or product idea. Prototypes can be used as a communication between stakeholders. Especially by different located teams, it's a good way to communicate your ideas among each other. There are different kinds of prototypes, digital and physical ones. Digital prototypes are, for example, FEM models, CID renderings, but also mock-ups. They are very cost-effective, nevertheless, they show a lot of information. They are a really good way to demonstrate your results to the different located stakeholders. Physical prototypes are sketches, paper prototypes, and 3D prints. The stakeholder you show your product to can experience the product by touching it. But you don't have to create the prototype completely on your own. You can rely on reference systems. For example, if you develop new wheels for a bicycle, use the frame of the old bicycle to validate the function of the wheels. During your product development process, it is important to validate your solutions continuously. Therefore, prototypes are a good way of testing your ideas. Create multiple prototypes, which represent different degrees of concretion. You have to think about what's the most important thing you want to present, and according to this, what's the best way of showing it. By deciding which prototypes is the best to demonstrate your desired functions, here is a guideline to help answering your questions. What is the primary purpose of the prototype? One intention can be the exploration of the design scope, demonstrating of an idea, or evaluation to select and make a decision of an idea. What is the most important function you want to present with your prototype? Which group of people should be confronted with the prototype? What does this group bring with it in terms of focus, background knowledge, preconceptions, motivations, and interests? A designer is interested in formal shaping. The developer, on the other hand, is concerned about the technical feasibility, and the user wants relevant everyday practice to be covered. On what aspect should understanding be created? At what level is the main interest? Does the prototype provide all the functions that the user wants? For example, effectiveness. Is the implementation of the functions such that the user can perform his tasks efficiently? Comprehensibility. Is it clear to the user which interaction steps have to be carried out in order to use a function? Are the consequences of an action comprehensible and understandable for the user? Regarding the layout and implementation. The selection of prototypes, tools and material. Which fidelity does the prototype need with regard to different dimensions? The fidelity compared to the final product. What usable resources do you have? Don't limit yourself to the given situations. Be creative and divert products from their intended use. How can the limits of the prototype be communicated? You have to make the stakeholder clear what the function they should evaluate is. For example, If the sketch of the product concept just describes the functionalities of the product, but not its visual appearance, you have to point out at which aspect the stakeholder should focus on. Tell him that the visual design of the product will be determined at a later date and that he should focus if the product functionalities are useful and if he likes to use such a product. Which confrontation method is the best to focus the attraction on the level of interest? A confrontation method describes the way people come into contact with a prototype or artifact. A paper prototype, for example, can be viewed, touched, and even be deformed. By demonstrating your product to the company, you are forced to present your product virtual because of the distribution of locations. Nevertheless, you have also options to let the stakeholder interact with the product and experience it. This may happen by creating a PowerPoint presentation where the stakeholder can decide by clicking which function will be demonstrated the next. This allows the stakeholder to experience the consequences of his actions. The prototype would be more attractive to him. If you have a paper prototype, make a short movie where you touch the prototype and deform it. Interact with the prototype and explain how the prototype feels. Tell the most important properties of your prototype and what benefit for the user it has. Sell your prototype the best possible way. Therefore, create a movie up to 3 minutes. Keep in mind, with prototypes, you can evaluate the functions of your product continuously during the developing process. Different stakeholders regard different kinds of prototypes. With prototypes, you can express and communicate your ideas to different stakeholders.